Dear my friends, I would like to solve a short question for you on fluid mechanics in external flow. Thus, I choose a question from Janna's fluid mechanics book on external flow. I wrote this question on a paper. Let's read this question firstly. So the question is, two cylinders are attached to a balance arm, as shown in figure 1. The cylinder on the left has a roughened surface. As you see, here we have a figure. The red one has a roughened surface. So the cylinder on the left has a roughened surface, as we said. Otherwise, they are identical. Identical means they have a same balance, same material. So a uniform flow of air is here. Air is directed upward past both of them. So, what velocity will the balance arm tilt clockwise? The question B is, what velocity will it tilt counterclockwise? So, we can choose the diameter of each cylinder as 15 centimeter. Okay. It is an air, the working fluid is air, and its properties can be taken as rho equal to 1.19 kilometer per meter cube, and then dynamic viscosity of the fluid is 18 by 10 to the minus 6 newton second per meter square. Okay, firstly, for this kind of question, both internal flow or external flow, we must calculate the Reynolds number if it is possible. Let's write the equation of Reynolds number. We can write the Reynolds number r equal to rho multiplied by u infinity times d over 2 dynamic viscosity. Okay. So we have the rho, we have d, and we have dynamic viscosity, but we don't have Reynolds number value, and already the question is asking to us u value. Okay, what we can do? We can decide the drag. So if number of value of Reynolds number between 4 by 10 to the 4 and then 4 by 10 to the 5. In this case, rough cylinder is less than that for smooth one. Okay, we know this one from fluid mechanics books or text. Okay. Otherwise, if we choose the right number of Reynolds number 4 by 10 to the 5 between the 10 to the 6. In this case, we have a vice versa situation that rough cylinder or rough material greater than smooth one. Okay, now we have at least Reynolds number value for this equation. Let's go and calculate the Reynolds number. Reynolds number we can choose as 4 by 10 to the 4 equal to, let's put the values of density, and then we don't know about an idea, use infinity, and then we have a diameter value, and then dynamic viscosity. 18 times 10 to the minus 6. From these equations, we can calculate u infinity as 4.03 meter per second. If we choose the Reynolds number equal to 4 by 10 to the 5, in this case, we will do the same thing as we know the other values, and if we put that values to equation, we can find the u infinity as 40.3 meter per second. Okay, if we compare, there are almost 10 times difference between these velocities. So what we can say after these results? We can say that if u infinity values greater than 40 by 3 meter per second, we can get the clockwise direction for the balance arm. So how can we do this? We can this, sorry, like that. So balance arm gonna be like this if we choose the u infinity greater than 40.3. So if we choose u values as like this, namely 4.03 and then less than u infinity and then less than 40.3 meter per second, so we can get the counter clockwise direction. It means that the balance arm, or yeah, we can do like this counter clockwise situation we can get. So in this case we solve the question that which velocity is necessary to get the balance arm from clockwise and then counterclockwise. Okay, I will solve different question on fluid mechanics from different subjects. You can follow my channel on YouTube and then you can get easily to my videos. Thank you so much, friends.